Hello, my name is Nikhil Gopalakrishnan. I like talking about money. I believe that all the people around us has the right and responsibility to make money. This channel, we are going to talk about all the experience which I have learned over a period of time about money. At the same time, what others have taught me and others' experience also will be shared here. I always like to know the concept of financial freedom. In financial freedom, what is financial freedom first of all? Financial freedom is nothing but all our necessary expenses. We have certain expenses anyway we have to incur on a monthly basis. So these expenses we have to meet no matter what. So we have a state of situation that we can meet our necessary expenses from an income which is generated automatically without any of our interferences. I have seen a friend of mine who has a rental income which is much higher than what he need for his necessary expenses. So that kind of people do not have to work. Even if he do not work also, his income generated from his rental income will be meeting his all the necessary and requirements. He don't have to worry about the fees he has to pay for his children, the petrol bill he has to pay for his vehicle, and any other expenses needed for his house. He don't have to worry because these expenses are met from his income generated out of his rental. Not necessary from rental, but any other income sources is needed enough for us to meet our regular expenses. Now we need to talk about how do we meet this state of financial freedom. So financial freedom is nothing but, we have talked about it, is that we are able to generate an income without our any of interferences, and that income is sufficient to meet our necessary expenses. So this is a state all of us really wanted to be, because if we have that kind of state, we don't have to really wake up in the morning and we have to dress up and go to work, because we don't have to worry about our monthly salary or monthly income generated or our regular businesses. So how do we achieve this? So in order to achieve that, first thing what we need to have is that a mindset and a belief that we can achieve this financial freedom. So in order to practice that, we should first of all understand that what is that financial freedom, and in order to achieve that financial freedom, what is the kind of number of what's the kind of amount we need to earn on a monthly basis. So that mindset and the knowledge of financial freedom is an important thing to achieve financial freedom. That's the first step. What is the second thing? Second thing is that we need to gain the knowledge of how the money work, how the finance work, and we need to have a budget. Budget for monthly expenses, budget for monthly savings and monthly investment. So if we have that numbers ready, we know that how do we ensure that we are allocating our fund accordingly. Our lifestyle is meant on a, whatever we needed, our family will be happy. At the same time, we should know that what is the amount of money we need to keep aside for our investing. So the third step, what we need, very important, is that we need to check very clearly that are we really sitting in a job or a business where we can achieve this financial freedom journey. If we are not sitting in a job where we are not going to progress or improve in terms of our income source, we cannot achieve financial freedom. So we need to check that whether this job or the business has the potential to generate an income we really able to achieve this financial freedom. So that reality check is very important for us to check that are we in the right track for financial freedom. We can check in a multiple way. We can discuss with our colleagues or people who are in the same qualification and see that what is the kind of income they are generating, and we can compare that, are we really matching that, or in case we are able to generate the income maximum we can get with our qualification, in that case we can try to see that what is the kind of skill set we can acquire in order to generate more income. That's the third step which we have to do it. And what's the fourth step? The fourth step is that we need to see that what is our short-term requirement. So maybe we will have a small expenses in terms of our kids' education fees, or we need to buy a car in a short time, or we need to buy certain necessity goods at home, things like a washing machine or things like a refrigerator. These are the things which is very, very necessary these days. Or we need to do some repairment at home, or even short-term finance can be our debts which we may have to clear off. So being a debt-free is another short-term goal we may have. Depends on the kind of a volume of debt we have. So we need to understand that what is that short-term investment requirement and start investing it. So that's the first step in terms of our investment journey. The fifth step is very important, that identify the long-term investment goals we have and keep on investing it. So it can be, if we have a kid, maybe small kid, and immediate or urgent requirement is that their education, their marriage, then we may have to buy a house. These are things are long-term asset acquisition goals. So these things we need to identify what is a kind of number we need to achieve and start investing in a small quantity on a monthly basis or regularly. So that is give us the confidence, and we can achieve our goals with small effort and disciplined approach. That's the fifth step. The sixth step is very important, that we need to keep this goal, financial freedom, and invest in a asset classes where we get income. Because in order to be financially freedom, in order to achieve financial freedom, we need to have an income source, which is, you know, we are able to get it on a monthly basis. So what kind of investment we will get monthly return? So it can be rental income, it can be returns we generate from bank FD or debt funds which we invest in mutual funds, or dividends we generate from dividend giving stocks. Multiple income sources are there. So it depends on your skill. In case if you can write a book and publish it, royalty is another source of income you can generate. Or investing in a business where the promoters are ready to give you monthly return, that is another way we can do it. It multiple ways. It depends on your risk profile and the ability to understand the asset class which you are going to invest. So it's very important that we identify that what is that financial freedom number, and in order to generate that income on a monthly basis, we should able to identify and invest. So that's the sixth step and last step. So if you're able to follow all these six steps, initially it will be difficult. Depends on your income source now and depends on your lifestyle you're going through. But if you are putting those budget in place, if you are making sure that you are sitting in a right job and business, and you are investing in different ways based on your goals, in that case, slowly and steadily, you will able to achieve financial freedom. Some people may achieve financial freedom in 3-4 years. Some people may take 10 years. Even then, it's worth exploring and achieving your financial freedom. We will be talking about topics related to money, topics related to savings, topics related to investing in our upcoming videos. Before that, if you have any questions related to the topic which we have discussed today, please ask in the comment box or the number given in the video. So next week, we will see you with a different topic in terms of money and investing. Thank you so much.